Captain's log, stardate 51652.3. It's been 12 hours, and our sensors show no sign of any Hirogen vessels. But their people are scattered throughout this region, and something tells me that the hunt for Voyager is far from over.
Captain, step down, please. Seven, you disobeyed my direct orders. And as a result, you condemned a sentient being to its death.
By doing so, I also diverted the Hirogen attack, an attack which would have destroyed us.
Maybe not. In any case, the decision wasn't yours to make.
The creature broke through the force field. I had no choice.
I didn't come here to debate your decision. I came here to inform you of the consequences. When you first came to Voyager, I decided to grant you the same liberties and freedoms of any crew member because I wanted you to be a part of this family. And I've been willing to accommodate your unique way of doing things, even when you rubbed somebody the wrong way or violated protocol. But this time I can't accommodate you. From this point forward, you will no longer have access to any primary systems on this ship, not without my direct authorization. If you attempt to circumvent me, I'll throw you in the brig. I still need your expertise in the astrometrics lab, if you're willing. If not, you can spend your time here in the cargo bay. Is that understood?
Yes. It is puzzling.
What's that?
You made me into an individual. You encouraged me to stop thinking like a member of the collective, to cultivate my independence and my humanity. But when I try to assert that independence, I am punished.
Individuality has its limits, especially on a starship where there's a command structure.
I believe that you are punishing me because I do not think the way that you do. Because I am not becoming more like you. You claim to respect my individuality. But in fact, you are frightened by it.
As you were.